It was the famous astrophysicist Carl Sagan, a key figure for NASA and renowned as a driving force for popular science, who said in the 1980s that we're all made of what he called, quote, star stuff. Since then, Sagan has been quoted far and wide, with his incredible assertion becoming a go-to fact for anyone with even a passing interest in physics. What's even more impressive, though, is that it's actually totally true. But what does it really mean? This is Unveiled, and today we're uncovering the extraordinary reasons why we really are all made of star stuff.
Are you a fiend for facts? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more fascinating content.
We know that there are a certain number of chemical elements in the universe. These elements make up every single piece of matter in existence, and they're all made by a process called nucleosynthesis, which literally means to create nuclei or atoms. The first elements were hydrogen and helium, made during the Big Bang when the universe was much hotter and more compact. It's thought that this state only lasted for around 20 minutes, but during those 20 minutes at the dawn of time, the universe went from being literally nothing to becoming mostly hydrogen, 75% hydrogen in fact. The rest was 24% helium and 1% other stuff, notably lithium. These are the three lightest chemical elements there are. The first stars were formed from them, and it was in those stars that the process of stellar nucleosynthesis began, and that heavier elements were created. Today, most of what appears on the periodic table can be, and has been, made inside of stars. This ability that the universe has to create heavier and heavier elements as time goes on is called galactic chemical evolution. Heavy elements, like iron for example, need to be fused inside stars from lighter, more abundant elements like hydrogen and helium. And if we trace it back far enough, we can see a cosmological chain of development for everything in existence. The first stars produce the first heavier elements, and then the next generation of stars use those elements to make more variations, and so on and so on. It's a process which is actually set to continue indefinitely until the ultimate end of the universe, meaning that as time goes on, newer, heavier elements will be created in other younger stars. And it's not as though it's something which is totally out of our hands either. Humans were able to replicate the conditions inside of stars through nuclear fusion here on Earth to create new elements for ourselves. Four additions to the periodic table, made official in 2016, were created this way: Nihonium, Mascovium, Tennessine, and Organessin. What's an incredible thought though, is that in a few billion years' time, the necessary ingredients for life itself might have completely changed from what they are now. Life forms in the distant future could well be based on currently new synthetic chemical elements like these, or even on something else entirely, something that we don't presently have a hope of synthesizing on Earth. Some scientists take the idea even further, and have gone so far as to suggest that as well as Earth's spatial habitable zone around the Sun, we currently live in a temporal habitable zone as well, because it's also thanks to the chemical, elemental conditions of today that we, in our current state, can exist in the universe right now. We have all the elements we need to grow and live in abundance at this point in time, exactly because the galactic chemical evolution is at just the right stage. But while that's all pretty incredible in itself, how is it that these elements created by stars find their way into us in the first place? Well, primarily it's down to supernovae. Supernovae, usually seen as massive explosions from a dying star, are bright and spectacular, but they also aren't all that common. In fact, they're one of the rarest ways for a star to die, because it's only the most massive stars which are able to go out with such a bang. An even smaller number of massive stars collapse into black holes, where they pull stuff in rather than blast it out. But even so, supernovae are a crucial reason why reality, including our existence, is the way it is. A supernova blasts all the rare elements that have been fused inside its particular stellar core out into space, scattering all of its physical properties far and wide. And eventually, gravity takes hold so that these elements can be made into new things, new stars, but also new planets, asteroids, and even organisms. It's because of this that some of the elements inside you, inside all humans, technically date all the way back to the moment of the Big Bang, 13.8 billion years ago. And after humans die and the sun expands and the Earth is one day destroyed, those same elements will find their way back into other stars and planets, perhaps ready to begin the cycle of creation again. Such a rebirth scenario is actually even more likely when you consider that most of the chemical elements that exist aren't necessary for life as we know it. In fact, there are only 6 elements essential for life on Earth: carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, and sulfur. While we might use other elements for other not quite so essential processes, as well as things like construction and technology, these are the fundamental ones that we need to live, and which make up all other forms of life on Earth. Plants, animals, microbes, and so on. And the most exciting thing of all is that none of these elements are unique to this world. They exist everywhere, meaning that theoretically there really could be life on other planets that functions in much the same way as we do. Or at least there could one day be life on other planets elementally similar to us. All planets could have access to the same base materials, depending on what's available at any one time in any one place. We know that there are billions of potentially habitable planets, at least spatially habitable, in just our own galaxy. But like Earth, they also exist in or close to a temporal habitable zone as well. The existence of life is still the product of an incredible coming together of all the necessary elements, plus billions of years of evolution. But if it's happened once, couldn't it happen again? For some scientists, it's crazier to think that life wouldn't grow in any other places when the universe seems to widely distribute all the requisite ingredients to create a world. We haven't yet traveled to any other stars to measure and record their composition at close quarters. But one experiment which has helped us to understand their elemental makeup and their significance to our own creation is the Apache Point Observatory Galactic Evolution Experiment, carried out across the 2010s by the Sloan Digital Sky Survey. It used a spectrograph to examine distant objects, translating the wavelengths of light emitted from them to calculate and quantify the elements that contribute to any given star's existence. And while it's also true that elements exist in different quantities and ratios inside a star compared to inside a human being, it's also true that traces of humanity and the building blocks of life on Earth can be found all across the cosmos. All of the elements that go into creating a human being were originally formed in the hearts of distant stars, potentially millions of light years away, and some even came from the Big Bang itself. And that's why we're all made of star stuff.
What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.